Shalom Aleichem, sweetest friends. We are continuing our series of Shirim in the Siddur Olah Asriya of Marna Rav Zatzal. And this year should be a special schluz. Mara Sena Miriam Bas Chana, Ritzkim and Chana, Gil Shana Bas Necha Gittel, Lazarus Shel Kayama, and for Rav Gil Amir Ben Penina, and Rav Aryeh Ben Dvora, and for Rav Avram Shraga Ben Malka Esther, and for He's Rafu Shleimer from Rishaya Mordechai, Ben Rachel Dvoira, and for Rav Mordechai Avigail, Rav Mordechai Gimple Ben Chaya Avigail. Bracha Matzlach Mokhom Ase Yedeim. We are now on the Bracha of Pokeach Ivrim, says the Rav. Bracha Atah Hashem Lekenam Ocholam Pokeach Ivrim, that's what the Siddur says. Blessed are you Hashem, the Master of the World, King of the World, who opens up the eyes of the blind. Kol Seder HaBrachot Halalu. הולך ומפרט את ההודעה של החזרת הנשמה אל קרבנו על ידי היקיצה. All of the Seder of these brachas goes and details the thanks we have to Hashem for returning our neshama when we woke up from our slumber. בחמלת מלך חי וקיים, with the mercy of the King who lives and exists, Adon Kol HaNeshamot, the Master of all the souls, HaMevutet Mikvar B'chlalutah, V'Birkat Elokai Neshama, that was already expressed in general in the Bracha Elokai Neshama. V'Hinu Matchilim, and we begin Achrei Odot HaMeforatot Sheb'Derech HaShlila, after the detailed gratitude in a negative way, Al Asher Lo Yarda Neshmatenu B'Yisoda Merum Ma'alata, that our neshama hasn't fallen from its exalted plateau. Shehi omedet ala on which she stands. V'ninu baim lidei hoda meforetet achiyuvit. And after all the shaloyasanis, we now go to the positive thanks. Lehodot al hahara pratit shel or haneshama chuzeret eleinu. To thank God for the specific light, for the of the slight of the soul that returns to us, and we start with being mityaches, with relating to the whole world, relating to our general sense, the sense of a vision, that gives us this pleasant, wonderful feeling, that fills our soul with the strength and the joy of God. Looking at all of creation, we woke up. We're thanking God for the world. Look at the world. Look, it's in front of you. It's gorgeous. Asher nelmu meitanu kalil al yedei tigrat yad ha-sheina, that was completely hidden from us through the hand of sleep. When we were asleep, we couldn't see the world. Now we can see the gorgeous world. Asher asta otanu ki evrim, sleep made us like a blind person. V'ninu madim l'Hashem chazdo bibirkat pokeach evrim. And we thank Hashem for His chesed in the bracha of pokeach evrim. So you start off your day. You want to relate to the world with this sense, that's this all-encompassing sense. You can look around. You can take in the whole world, everything you see. And you thank God that for this vision that you didn't have when you were sleeping. Baruch atah Hashem Elokeinu Melech Olam Malbish Arumim. We thank God for enclothing the naked. Ha'erom hu mirashem banu. Mirashem banu. Roshim shel genai ve'yader ha'kavod. When a person is naked, it is a genai, it's a disgrace, it's a lack of kavod. Ha'menaged le'teferet ha'adam. That opposes the glory of man. Hinenu muchachim litgonen negdo belevushenu. We are compelled to protect ourselves against this bizayon of the glory of man with our clothing. Mani mechubdase, the Gemara says in Shabbos Kuf Yedalet. Rabbi Yochanan will call his clothing what honors him, because naked is a disgrace. Imagine a person who would have to walk around naked. It would be disgraceful. Clothing gives us covet. V'achreach ha-musari hazeh asher nata b'kirbeinu yotzer ha-adam. And this moral compulsion that the one who created man implanted within us. אחרי שכבר נקבע המושג שהעירום הוא דבר ששולל את הכבוד, after the concept has already been established that nakedness negates honor, זה הכרח בעצמו מתת אלוקים הוא, המעיד על זיו הנשמה. This necessity, this compulsion itself is a gift of God, which shows the shine of the neshama. In other words, this whole notion that a Rome, why does it have to be that being naked is a lack of covet? That's what God made. God made it that way. Nothing has to be. Hashem made it that way. That without clothing, it's a disgrace, and with clothing, it's an honor. And that shows that we have a neshama that emanates ha'atzula, that emanates mizohar kvod shel mala, from the shine of honor of above. Ha'chaya b'kirbeinu v'chofefet aleinu, that lives within us and dwells over us. We have an honorable soul. The soul is called kavod. L'mani zamercha kavod v'lo yidom. The soul is kavod, that my soul should sing to you and not be silent. Ura kvodi, my soul should awaken. The Baal HaMoor in his Hakdamah to Brachos talks about this. The soul is kavod. So we have this soul of kavod, of honor, of dignity. And when we're naked, our dignity is stripped of us, literally. So by putting on clothing, that gives us kavod. V'hine tochen ha-bracha hazot kafulu. The content of this bracha is dual. Hoda'a l'chush ha-nafshi ha-adin shelanu, shenata Hashem b'kirbeinu. שנינו על ידו מתלבשים מלבושי כבוד. Thanks for this very subtle and gentle emotional feeling that God implanted within us of כבוד. שנינו על ידו מתלבשים מלבושי כבוד. Through which because of which we enclose ourselves in clothing of honor. In other words, when we thank Hashem Malbish Arumim, we're thanking Hashem for this feeling that we have of kavod and of lack of kavod, the two sides. And we appreciate that we're people of honor, that we have human dignity. Just about the worst thing you could do to a person is take away his dignity. So we thank Hashem for this feeling of being dignified, of being important, of being honorable. ועל ההזמנה החומרית המציאותית, and we're also thanking God, we said it's dual. The second side is that we're thanking God for the material possibility, מציאס, שממציא יוצר כל ברוך הוא בחסדו, that God made, לבריאותיו האנושיות, for his human beings, את הבגדים לחסות את מערומיהם, clothing to cover our nakedness. בשני הדרכים הללו ביחד, in these two ways together, דרך הנטייה הרוחנית ודרך ההזדמנות החומרית, פועל צור העולמים, these two ways together, via the spiritual inclination and the material inclination, God works. מחיי חיים ברוך הוא, the one who gives life, his name should be blessed. את פעולת חסדו הגדול, that's the way he activates his great chesed. Shanu varchim aleha malbish arumim. We make this brach of malbish arumim. For these two chesedim, the one chesed of human dignity, that we feel dignity, we feel the need to wear a malbush kavod. And number two, that he actually gave us the clothing. So we don't really think of that when we say malbush arumim in the world. We say, okay, we have clothing. But what about the dignity that connects to the clothing? This need for clothing, and then the actual clothing on top of that. And it even strengthens it. In other words, once you think about how terrible it would be now, how lacking dignity you would feel if you didn't have clothing, then you can appreciate how dignified you feel when you do have clothing. Besides the fact that it gives you warmth in the cold weather, etc. But here Rav Kook emphasizes the kavod aspect, the neshama. We have the soul of kavod, and we thank Hashem for the physical clothing that He gave us. That we, I think it's safe to say that we take for granted. We've never not had clothing, so thank you so much, Hashem. Wouldn't it be terrible without? And how great it is with. So Baruch Hashem b'siyat d'shmai, we learned two brachas, and we have so much more to do. We should be zoche l'ilmod u'lam l'shma v'las l'kaim z'kol v'yisam t'rasa v'hava, amen v'amen. Shalom, shalom, sweetest and most beloved friends.